Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the GDP, gross domestic product. Before going to that, generally we call the people either the poor people and the rich people like that. How can we estimate them? As per their income capacities, we are going to categorize them as the poor people or rich people according to their family income. Okay, what about one country? For example, for a country, here we take the value of goods and services produced in that country. We can estimate the total income of that country. Here we have to come to one conclusion that GDP means gross domestic product means here the value of goods and services produced in a year in a country is called GDP. So how can we estimate the GDP? How can we calculate the GDP? Here already I said we have to add the value of the goods. How can we add? For example, we take the rice. 10,000 kgs of rice is produced and it is sold at the rate of 25 rupees per kg. We get the 2,50,000 rupees. And also another example is there. For example, 5,000 coconuts are there and we sell them at the rate of 10 rupees for each. We get the 50,000 rupees. In this way, we calculate the value of the goods. Okay, to estimate GDP, we have to count the goods produced. But so many goods are produced. We cannot count them easily. It is impossible to count all the goods. But it is easy. The economist suggested that there is a easy way to count the goods. That is, we have to add the value of the goods produced. There is a good example to estimate the GDP here. For example, one farmer produced 100 kgs of rice and he sold at the cost of rupees 25 per kg. Then he gets 2500 rupees. He sold to the rice miller. Again, the rice miller make out the rice. Then the rice miller takes out 80 kgs of rice and 20 kgs of husk. And he sold the rice at 40 rupees per kg and he sold husk at the rate of 20 rupees per kg. Finally, he got 3,600 rupees over. Then, one hotelier purchased the rice from the rice miller by paying 3,600 rupees. And he used the rice and he made idlis and doshas and other things in their hotel. And finally, he got 5,000 rupees on making them. So, how can we calculate the GDP here? Shall we add the first 2,500 and in second stage 3,600 and in the final stage 5,000? Can we add these three things? Is it right? No, it is not right. If we add these three stages value, it will become more and the value is increased, but the goods are changed their position only, because paddy is changed into rice and rice is changed into idli, dosha, some other things. But only value is added here. So to count correctly. We have to add only value added at each stage. Stage 1 at paddy stage, stage 2 at rice mill, rice stage, and stage 3 at hotel. Then we have to count the value added. How can we count, or how can we add the value added at each stage? For example, first two, the farmer sold at 2500 rupees. It's okay. Then in the second stage, we got the 3600. We have to subtract the first two value, 3600 minus 2500. Then the value added here is only 1100 rupees here. Then we go to the third stage. The hotelier, he got 5000, but already he paid the 3600 rupees to the rice mill owner. We must subtract the 3600 from the 5000 rupees. Then he got the benefit 1400. Finally, in the first stage 2500 we got, in the second stage the value added 1100, and in the third stage we added the value of 1400. Finally, it equals to the 5000 rupees. It is the one way. It is the one way of counting. There is another way of counting. What is that? This is a lengthy process, value adding. But it is one thing is easy to estimate the GDP is that we have to take the final value of the goods. We have to take the value of final goods. What are the final goods and what are the intermediate goods? We have to know here. The final goods here, the idli or dosa, these are called the final goods, because the final goods are ready to consume. Then they are called as the final goods. So the final goods are not used further in producing goods to be sold. What are the intermediate goods? Here the inputs for making the idli, dosa or other final goods, we have used the rice as the input. It is called as the intermediate good because it is not used as final. It is used for making another goods. So it is called intermediate goods. For making any final goods, there are some intermediate goods also there. We are using that as inputs to make the new good. There is an example. Notebook and car are the final goods. Here, there are some intermediate goods are used for making the notebook is paper, water and the wood pulp. Next, for making the car, there are some intermediate goods like iron, steel, spare parts, plastic, rubber, glass. There is another example. For example, one family is using the rice for themselves, and of course they are making the idlis and doshas for their consumption. But here the doshas and idlis are not used to be sold. So it is final good at family. Okay, finally we came to one conclusion that there are three sectors we know. The value of goods and services produced in each sector is counted for counting the GDP. It is nothing but we have to take the value of the all goods and services produced in three sectors in a country for a particular year. Okay, here there is a financial year. We have to take these values per year. which year? Financial year. What is the financial year? In every year, we have to estimate this value from the April to March. For example, 2020 April to 2021 March 31st of. It is called financial year. The government is estimating in this financial year. Generally, to calculate the GDP, we have to take the market value of the goods and services. But here, some of the goods or services not sold or purchased in the market. So these are not covered in the GDP. For example, at our homes, our mother is working. She is cooking and cleaning and doing some other works for us. It is unpaid work. The service is not paid by us in many instances. So, this type of unpaid work is not included in the GDP. Here is a graph showing the GDP by three sectors. It is given for the 1973-74 year and for the 2013 and 14 year. We can see agriculture was the largest producing sector in 1972 and 73, and service sector was the largest producing sector in 2011 and 12. The total value of production of goods and services in India increased approximately 15 times between 1972 to 2013 and 14. The growth rate of GDP is given in this table. We can see how can we get the growth rate of GDP. For example, in the 2010 and 11 year, the growth rate of GDP is 9.32 is given here. To calculate growth rate of GDP, first we have to subtract the previous year GDP from the present year GDP, and it is divided by the previous year into 100. Then it equals to the growth rate of GDP.